Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to another episode of Sonic Adventure 2 Battle Story Mode Playthrough. In our last episode, we continued the dark story, and we played as Dr. Eggman and Rouge, and we did one stage for both characters and a boss battle for both of them. And when we left off, we had just defeated the R1 flying dog robot boss with Rouge, and it's time for us to pick up from there. So, let's get to it, shall we?
This is Rouge. I've got a small problem. I can't believe that I'm trapped inside this locked safe with a Chaos Emerald. I guess I won't be able to call myself a treasure hunter anymore.
Alright, here we go. Time for another shadow level with White Jungle. Cut through the jungle in 10 minutes. So yeah, this is basically Shadow's version of Green Forest, except it's in the rain and you have a longer timeline. But 10 minutes is plenty of time. It is a time limit, and you do want to get to the end of the level before then, but it's not that big of a deal at all. 10 minutes is plenty of time to explore every nook and cranny of the level and get every item and whatnot with time to spare. You'd have to be deliberately taking a long time to not make it to the gold ring before time runs out. And it's actually in here that we will get a very important upgrade for Shadow. You'll see it when we get to it. I won't spoil anything at the moment. Watch out for those tank enemies with spikes on their backs. You can only kill them by somersaulting into them. Don't even try to jump on them. And watch what happens here. For some reason, I pushed the button to do a somersault to go under that wooden wall, and he didn't do it, and he ended up getting smashed by the weight. That was really weird. Just an example of the glitchy nature of this game, I guess. And yeah, I landed behind the robot, so I didn't have to kill it. So yeah, this is actually a pretty, even though it's relatively late in the game, especially if you're doing the dark story before, especially if you're doing the dark story after the hero story, this level's actually pretty easy. It's not that hard at all. It really isn't. It's only hard if you let it be hard. I know that didn't make much sense, but bear with me. Those of you that follow me and are subscribed to me, you should know that a lot of stuff I say probably doesn't make sense. But apparently I'm doing something right because I have over 170 subscribers, so take that for what it's worth. So anyway, it is right here where we get Shadow's upgrade for this level. Right in this room. The air shoes. These serve the same function as Sonic's light speed shoes. These will allow Shadow to do the light dash, which is required, of course, to beat this level. And it's also required for certain challenges in other levels. Maybe not required, but it's recommended. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. And if I'm correct, we're actually approaching the end of the level right about now. It shouldn't be that much farther that we have to go. And there's the Golden Beetle. We want to get that. An easy 1,000 points. Can't pass that up now, can we? And, yeah, I just walk into the capsules. I don't want to risk doing a homing attack off the edge and getting killed. Rather not deal with that. And, I stop here to kill the enemies and get some free points. Nothing wrong with that, I suppose. Grab this vine and goal ring. There you go. That is White Jungle.
Ultimate victory.
And my A-rank streak continues. But let me tell you, folks, it's not gonna last forever. So anyway, moving on.
Hey, that's...
That blue hedgehog again, of all places.
I found you, Faker.
Faker? I think you're the fake hedgehog around here. You're comparing yourself to me? Huh. You're not even good enough
I'll
to be
you
my
eat those words.
All right, here we go. In the hero story, it was Sonic against Shadow. Now it's Shadow against Sonic. Same rules as... Well, same principle, really. Same strategy and everything as it was when you were playing as Sonic. And you might notice the life counter is down one life from what it was a couple moments ago. That's because this is a different take of this boss fight, but... In this fight, I do a pretty good job of beating him without getting killed, although I do have a few close calls, like, right there. I almost ran right off. That would have been embarrassing, but there you go.
No time to hang out with the likes of you.
Chalk one up for Shadow.
Before the island blows up with you on it!
Blows up?
Chaos Control!
Shadow, what do you think it's like on Earth?
The professor said his life's work was dedicated to all of those who live down there. He once told that the reason for his existence was making people happy through the power of science.
Shadow...
Maria, I just don't know anything anymore. I often wonder why I was created, what my purpose is for being here. Maybe if I go down there, I will find the answers. Maybe. Maria.
Why so melancholy? That was so unexpected, so unlike you, Shadow, to come and rescue me. But your ability to use the Chaos Control certainly comes in handy.
You know, I didn't come to save you. I came back for the Chaos Emeralds.
Yeah, but then again, that's not the whole story, is it?
Everything is ready to go!
Are you sure? We only have 6 of the 7 Chaos Emeralds, you know?
That's more than enough for the demonstration. So let's get the show on the road!
Demonstration? What could that possibly mean? We're about to find out.
Citizens of Earth, lend me your ears and listen to me very carefully. My name is Dr. Eggman, the world's greatest scientist, and soon to be the world's greatest ruler. Now witness the beginning of the greatest empire of all time.
That looks familiar. Oh man, not again! We already went through this once! Oh, there goes the moon. Again. Eggman means business. Or does he?
Why are you so upset? Well, that was really impressive. You've managed to create complete havoc on the whole planet. Does this now mean we control the planet and can do as we choose?
At this rate, the cannon will take too much time to charge up. If you want to unleash its full potential, you'll need all 7 Chaos Emeralds.
Where in the world have you been?
Something happened?
Our threats fell on deaf ears.
Look at you, throwing a tantrum like a little kid. How totally embarrassing.
Don't forget your end of the bargain, Batgirl. What about that last Chaos Emerald? We had a deal, right? So where is my emerald?
Here you go. I found this.
Why didn't you show me this before?
This? Station Square saved from a life-threatening missile attack. The city has awarded its famed prize to the boy who saved Station Square. Miles Tails Per Hour was given the Chaos Emerald as a testament of his heroic deed at a ceremony held at City Hall.
This makes things a whole lot easier. Hurry, go back to Earth and find them fast. I want that Chaos Emerald!
Did you get that?
Soon enough, Maria.
This is Rouge reporting. Currently, I have not been able to confirm that Shadow is the ultimate life form or not. I will continue my research on Project Shadow and have a follow-up report very shortly. Just a reminder, don't forget about my jewel.
We have a little double agent in the works here. Anyway, time for another Rouge level, Route 280. Take a guess what this is. Yes. It's a driving level. Oh god. yes. If you watched my earlier portion of this playthrough when I did the Tails version of this stage, you already know my opinion of these levels. I don't like them. I really don't. So anyway, what I found interesting in that last cutscene. Shadow says, our threats fell on deaf ears. What is that supposed to mean? Hello, you just blew up, like, half of the moon. Like, seriously, how can someone not take you seriously when you literally destroy half of the moon? Like, somebody has a weapon powerful enough to do that, I'd be like, okay, I'll do whatever you want. Just don't aim that thing at me. So anyway, in this stage, the concept is exactly the same as the one that Tails did in the Hero Story. It's basically get from one area of the course to the other, one end of the course to the other, within the time limit, passing through checkpoints and getting rings for boost, and trying not to hit anything, which is harder than it sounds. And I'm going to say something right now. I keep talking about how I have a nice A-rank streak going, which goes back to, episode 9. Well, let's just say that streak is going to end right here with this stage. Because I'm lucky if I can get a B-rank on either of these two stages. Yeah, take that, you stupid taxi. That may have been the cash cab. I hope it was. I don't particularly care for that show. I don't hate it, but I'm not a fan of that show. I think there are better shows on Discovery Channel. Like Mythbusters. But enough about what I like to watch on TV. Back to this, although I can't really say anything about this stage that I didn't already say about Route 101 with Tails, but the good thing about this is that once you do, assuming that you do the Tails level before you do this, once you do this stage, and you've completed both of the driving stages, you'll actually unlock the two-player kart racing game, which is actually pretty fun. And I do believe we're actually close to the end of this stage, mercifully. So we're getting there, and take out a minivan, because I can. And I do believe that is the finish line of sorts. But there's still a little bit more to this level. And this is actually the final straightaway, and Tails and the Tornado should be coming into view soon enough. Right about now. And I'm telling you, I really cut it close with this time. I just barely get a C rank. If I had been a half second later, I would have gotten a D rank. But nonetheless, that level is over, thank goodness, and we get another emblem for our troubles, which I guess is a nice consolation prize. And there you go, two-player kart racing is now available. And with that, that's pretty much it for this episode of Sonic Adventure 2 Battle Story Mode Playthrough. We have now gotten deeper into the Dark Side story, and it looks like things are indeed getting serious. So if you guys liked what you saw here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would really appreciate it. And this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. See you folks in the next episode.